is a forest with so many snakes. The ground is alive.
Hanas, discernment. When I labored with the Bringer of Gifts to forge the Rings of Power, even Galadriel did not discern how the rings would reshape the world. Sauron's fair form masked his true nature, and neither the Lady of Light nor I could discern how the story would end.
Get any ideas about filching from these supplies? We're here to keep them safe, you lazy dogs!
You see those supplies? Soon they'll be ours.
Right, Lord! Return to the fight!
Did you hear that?
Kneel before me!
Minas Ithil is on Gondor's frontier, so we have few occasions for the grand balls and masquerades that are surely common events in the capital city. Fine dresses like this one are worn for ceremony, funerals and weddings mostly, not for lordly entertainment. I wonder if the noble families of Minas Tirith spared a thought for us, holding all of Mordor at bay while they danced.
Another fine garment thoughtlessly cast away.
Who in Mordor would wear such a thing in days like these?
Are neither the only denizens of Mordor, nor the first. Easterlings and Haradrim have settled here from time to time, often at the Dark Lord's invitation. They are scarce today, but one can still find their strange artistic carvings scattered in places from Nern to the City of the Corsairs.
An artifact of the Haradrim. Interesting.
Few find their way this far north, and for that, your nation should be grateful.
To most Gondorians, this midnight urn is a simple pot of clay, but to the denizens of Minas Ithil, it represented shared sacrifice that only those who live on the frontier understand. For centuries, the name of every able-bodied resident of Minas Ithil was placed in the midnight urn, and at sunset, a name was drawn. That person would have to patrol the city's walls until sunrise. The task was ceremonial once we had a professional army. But that made it no less important. From our earliest days, it was always a neighbor watching from the walls. I was 10 the first time they drew my name, and I've never been prouder, though I could barely see over the parapet.